So maybe you're just getting started out with SEO and you don't have any money to pay for keyword research tools. How do you go about doing keyword research for free? That's what we're going to be discussing in this video. We're going to be going over some tools that you can use for keyword research, and these tools are all going to be free. Now, before we jump into this video, I just want to make a little bit of a call to action here. We've been getting a lot of viewers recently, and the number of subscribers that we've been getting has been stagnating a little bit. If you are continuously watching the videos, make sure to subscribe to the channel and also turn on notifications so that you get notified when a video goes live every single Tuesday. Now, with that all out of the way, this week's video is going to be about free keyword research tools for SEO. The reason why we're covering this week is because last week we uploaded a video which was titled SEO for Beginners, this video right here. And, you know, the main pillar or one of the main pillars of SEO is keyword research. So if you're just a beginner starting out, or your business has a low budget and, you know, you can't afford to pay, you know, $100, $200 a month for some of these tools out there, you know, this video is going to give you an alternative to be able to do keyword research on a low budget. So with that all being said, let's jump into the video and let's get into how you can do keyword research for free. So the first tool I want to talk about is this extension right here. It's called Keywords Everywhere. It's a free Google Chrome extension. And the way it works is very, very simple. For example, if you type in a keyword like engine oil, my car recently needed engine oil, so let's go with that. If you type in a keyword like engine oil, for example, you're gonna get a bunch of results, you know, normal page. But what you'll notice is the actual search bar up here will give you search volume for this keyword. Now, this is a global sort of number, so it's not going to be specific to your country, which is, you know, one downside to using free tools. It's not as accurate, but it gives you a nice picture of what you're sort of working with, and you'll be able to tell whether or not it's actually going to be worth your time to go after a keyword like this. Another great point about this tool is the CPC. It will actually give you the cost per click of this keyword. Now, once again, this isn't like the most accurate metrics because it's worldwide and it's not specific to a region. So, you know, don't take it for what it is. Actually, we're going to be going over how to actually get like more accurate data later, but this is the first tool that I want to show you guys. The competition here, I'm not sure if this is actually the organic competition or the PPC. I'm pretty sure that it's the PPC competition and not the organic. So, you know, this keyword, it's saying that it would be pretty difficult to bid for because it's almost at a one. I think one is the highest score. So this tool is great. You know, it gives you a bunch of suggested options along with the initial keyword that you type in. So it goes into more specific types of oil like 5W30. And then because I'm in the UK, it's suggesting Halfords engine oil. You know, it gives you a bunch of related keywords and then other keywords that people have searched for along, like, similar to this keyword. So it's a great tool, you know, it's free. The way you download it is literally just type in extensions into Google, and then you're going to come across the Chrome Web Store. Just click on that, and then all you have to do is literally type in Keywords Everywhere, and it's literally this one right here. And once you download it, what they'll do is they'll send you an API key via email. You just have to give them your email. And so once you put the API key into the tool, you have access to it. You know, you can turn it off if you want to. And overall, it's just a great tool. Like, it's free, so you can't really complain about it. So what is the second tool that you can use for keyword research? Uber Suggest. This is a tool created by Neil Patel, and so Neil Patel is one of the biggest sort of marketers out there in terms of his personal brand. You know, he works mostly with large corporations, and the reason why he's actually putting out free tools is because he's pretty much maxed out the amount of traffic that he can generate from his marketing stuff. So now he's moving on to tools to generate even more leads. And one of the tools that he offers for free is Uber Suggest. So if we type in engine oil again, it's going to give us a bit more detail than the first tool. You have to fill in this captcha just to verify that you're a human. And then once it's done, so the good thing about this tool is the fact that you can actually select your region. You know, I'm in the UK, so if I'm working with a client in the UK, then I can type in United Kingdom. If I'm working with someone in the US, I can type in United States. If I'm working with someone in Israel, Egypt, Libya, wherever they may be, you know, this tool has all the options available to you, and it's going to give you search volume specific to that region. And from what I've found in taking a look at this tool and comparing it with, you know, Google AdWords data, which is, you know, the source of all this stuff, this tool is extremely accurate when you compare it to, you know, other keyword tools that are free. Another great thing about this tool is it will give you the SEO difficulty and the paid difficulty, and it separates them out. So as we can see, so you know how I mentioned that the other keyword tool for engine oil said that it was a 0.98. Well, that is actually PPC from the looks of things, and it would definitely be difficult to bid for this keyword. But it gives you the SEO difficulty, and it's at 50, and it gives you the percentage. So it says that you'd have a 50% of ranking in the top 10. So overall, like the tool is great. It gives you a bunch of, you know, different options as well, just like the other tool. It goes into a bit more detail, and it gives you the top ranking sites on that page, so you can analyze, you know, all of these pages and come up with a strategy for your own page. So it works great. Now, those are the first two tools, and you know, these are third party tools, so they're obviously not going to be as accurate. Keywords Everywhere, the free extension, is great. It's not that accurate, but it gives you a good idea. And if you want to go into a little bit more detail, then I'd highly recommend using Uber Suggest. And there's another tool that you can actually go to, which is called Answer the Public. And this keyword tool allows you to actually input any keyword. Okay, engine oil, type that in, get questions. And this is going to give you a list of questions all around engine oil. So this will allow you to actually, you know, puff up your content a little bit. So, you know, these are some keywords that you can include, you know, maybe not something like this, for example. You wouldn't want that to be on your page, or maybe you would. Maybe you want to, you know, make an extensive resource about engine oil and how engine oil works and how it's made and how engine oil filters work. Like, these are all topic ideas. This is, you know, this is stuff that people are all searching for. And so if you can actually create content around these things, then you can see how, even if, you know, the Keywords Everywhere tool is saying zero searches per month for some of these, but the only reason why they've come up is because people are searching for these. And if you were to, you know, go through these topics and rank for all of these keywords, whether that's using one page or whether that's using 10 pages, whatever it takes, you know, from what I can see, there's a good number. There's like 40 to 50 keywords right here. So at 10 searches per month, even at 10 searches per month at a very low end, you know, some of them have 260, you could be getting, you know, another 500 to 1,000 visitors per month just from this one engine oil keyword. So you can see how you can sort of expand out and cover all aspects of engine oil just from using this tool, because it gives you all the questions that people want answers to. So that is the third tool, and the fourth tool that we're going to be going over is the Google Planner. Now, with the Google Planner, you do have to have an advertising account, and you don't actually have to spend any money with the ad account. You just need to set it up and put in your card details. Of course, like, it's not going to charge you anything because you're not going to be running any ads. You're just going to be using the Keyword Planner to actually take a look at search volume data. if you don't have an AdWords account, or your payment, you know, payment details aren't in there, then you can use the planner, but it gives you estimates of the data. Like, it might say average monthly searches from 10 to 100. Like, it won't give you like a clear cut number. So if you want the clear cut number, then you'd have to actually use your card details and then put your card details, and it will give you all the information that you need. Those are the four free SEO tools that you can use for keyword research. If you enjoyed this video, make sure to leave a like. And if you want to see new SEO videos every single week, make sure you subscribe to the channel, turn on notifications to get notified when videos go live. But other than that, I want to thank you for watching this video. My name is Volkan, the founder of Clicks from Search, and I will see you on the next video.